Last video, I talked about Street Fighter and its impact on the gaming industry. Now we take a look at its competitor, Mortal Kombat.
Now, I'm not as familiar with Mortal Kombat as I am with Street Fighter, so bear with me.
Mortal Kombat was originally made by just four people, Ed Boon, John Tobias, John Vogel, and Dan Forden.
That's quite an accomplishment for 1991.
Anyways, after many trial and error attempts, the development team realized that it was Street Fighter's success that got ideas going, and thus Mortal Kombat was born.
And the rest was history. Or was it?
What made Mortal Kombat stand out was its use of digitized actors instead of cartoony sprites.
This wasn't very common to do because it was more expensive to make.
Despite the success, the game drew criticism in 1992 for one thing, the violence.
Yep, but this was just the beginning.
As if this wasn't enough, there already was a moral panic over gun violence. Now wait a minute, this sort of panic was going on in the 1970s and former Surgeon General C. Everett Koop believed that violent content was potentially addicting. How can we add more fuel to the fire? Let's add in the state of the industry as well as Nintendo and Sega's rivalry.
So what happened next?
Congressman Herb Kohl and Joe Lieberman showed footage of both Mortal Kombat and Night Trap to show why regulation was needed.
I can understand something needs to be done, but why should Congress get involved?
Because if the game industry didn't do anything, Congress would.
Between you and me, if Congress had stepped in, things would have been much worse.
So with that, the video game industry created the IDSA, which served as an advocacy group to what we now know today as the ESRB.
So with all that, all is good, right?
Well, not quite. In 1993, Mortal Kombat 2 was released in arcades, and along with it came some surprises.
Not counting the commercial and critical success, but something else.
The game introduced two new finishers, Babalities and Friendships.
This was the industry's way of saying this video games causes violence thing is absurd.
What's even more surprising is that Nintendo got in on the action.
Who knew?
There are two sayings that fit this story well. Everyone wants a piece of the pie, and controversy creates cash.
Of course, as time went on, Mortal Kombat started to toy around with the gameplay mechanics more than Street Fighter.
Just to name a few things, Mortal Kombat 3 introduced animalities, Mortal Kombat 4 went 3D, Harakiri in Deception, Create a Fatality in Armageddon, and so on.
I could go on, but you get the idea. Next time we finish this and see which franchise is better.